For years, I have been using Excire Search to keyword my photos to make it easy to find any photo inside of Lightroom. And Excire has two versions. They have Excire Search, which is a Lightroom plugin, and they have Excire Foto, which is a standalone app. Excire Search has been my go-to because everything's inside of Lightroom. The only downside of it is that it is a resource hog. It takes a lot of resources to build its index. It takes a lot of storage to maintain the database. And when you are opening and closing Lightroom, everything slows down when Excire is activated. Other than that, it's a fantastic application to basically build up all the keywords you want, to find the photos, to find whatever you need, but also to write those keywords to your metadata in Lightroom. There's been another software that has come out called On1 Keyword, I believe, or On1 Keywording. I don't remember exactly. It's from On1. I have loved On1 software for a very long time. I never used any of it as my true workflow solution because there was always little quirks that just didn't work well for me for that purpose. But I've always enjoyed the innovations that they've done over time. And they have a standalone app that, again, works well, but it's its own system. It's not inside of Lightroom. And so I, again, don't use it in my workflow on an ongoing basis. Then there is Peakto. Now, I've done another video on Peakto and Avalanche, a sister application that company makes. And Peakto is a standalone software. It's kind of like On1's and it's kind of like Excire Photo. It's a standalone application that actually will index every photo from Instagram and Apple Photos and Lightroom CC and Lightroom Classic and Aperture, if you still have an Aperture catalog, and so on and so on and so on, Capture One and so on. It makes it easy for you to search via AI to find a photo or similar photos, among so many other things, give you some insights about your work and things like that. Now, Peakto is great, but like Excire, it takes up a lot of storage. The database is quite large. You can put it on an external drive, the database, if you don't want it on the internal, whereas Excire, it lives wherever your Lightroom catalog is. So you basically have very little control over where its data is stored. Now, Peakto has just released Peakto Search. It is a combination of an app along with a Lightroom plugin. And so far, it's not building a very large database, which is quite nice because it's not taking up too much storage on my machine. It does take up a good amount, but not nearly as much as Peakto or the others do. Now, with that said, this is a standalone app that sort of just sits up at the top of your Mac machine. I don't know if there's a Windows version. I don't use Windows. I don't know if there's a Windows version coming. Again, I don't use Windows, so I'm only paying attention to the Mac version. But basically, it lives at the top. And the reason why they say it runs so fast is because it's always running in the background, as long as you have it open, so that the indexing could happen slowly over time, except for the initial. The initial takes up a lot of resources on your machine, a lot of RAM to build that first index. You can index multiple Lightroom catalogs if you want as well. And when you open a brand new catalog you've never opened while Peakto has been installed, or Peakto Search rather has been installed, it even prompts you to index it if you want to. Similar to if you use Excire, if you close Lightroom, it does say wait till Peakto Search stops doing its thing or whatever, but it's actually much faster than Excire's is. Okay, so this is what the Peakto app looks like. So far, this is the beta version. I wish that I could go to the preferences and tell it where I want the files to be stored, but I can't. That's not an option. Maybe down the road they'll add the ability, because Peakto, the bigger application, actually has the ability to say where you want your indexing stored. This does not. Okay, now what is cool is that it does. I have my main catalog index. You can see 422,000 images, 6,719 videos, all inside of this catalog, okay? Now, this is the standalone app. I could search by prompt, which actually brings me to here. I can search by similar images, which brings me to here. You can see I did do a search for fireworks at one point, and it actually maintained that. Now, what you can also do is I can go from inside of Lightroom, I can go to File, Plugin Extras, and then Peakto Search for Lightroom. I could search for similar images, and I'm gonna have it do this, the Space Needle, that's in Seattle, Washington. And you can see it's actually going to bring it right up, and it's going to show me all of the similar photos. I can hit see all. It's going to bring 617 similar photos. And you can see they all look like the space, you know, it even got the cityscapes that have it in the background. How cool is that? It found, I wonder if it's going to do anything that is not. Okay, so this is Brooklyn. So it didn't do it perfectly, but it did a pretty good job. You can actually, if I go back up, you can't there. But if you do it by, interesting, if you do it by keyword, then you can actually say to give it like a restriction. So for example, if I was to go here and I was to say fireworks, I could search all catalogs or just the open one, tolerance, got to be very close, and let's collapse that. And now you can see I got just the fireworks photos here. There should be nothing but fireworks here, right? I could go and make that more tolerant and it would expand as needed. Now, if I go back to, let's do a different prompt, search by prompt. Oop, I clicked on the photo. If you click on the photo, it actually brings the photo up inside of your Lightroom catalog. This takes a little bit of time for some reason, but let's say I type in the word cat. You can see it did bring up a bunch of cats that I have in my catalog. I have a lot. I do have two cats, as well as family has additional cats. So I've got a lot of pictures of cats in my catalog, and it can, like, again, restrict how tolerant I want it to be for this, the for that word. I could say I want a black cat, and now we've got only black cats. This is one of my favorite examples. I believe I did the same exact example when I showed you Peakto, the main software as well. But what I really like about this is that it's always indexing in the background. I love that it works inside of Lightroom and outside at the same time. I don't have to use a separate application. I can just have it, pick it up. Now, there's some things that are not here yet. I'm assuming they're adding things that Excire have that Peakto does not. Or Peakto Search rather does not. For example, I would love for, once it has all the keywords indexed in its own database, for the ability to take all those keywords and write it, all of them, to my Lightroom database. So for example, in Lightroom, if I do have black cat not indexed, not actually in Lightroom as in the metadata of all the pictures of black cats, I would love for Peakto Search to write those to it. That would be amazing because I love to have all my keywords inside the metadata so that I can pull them up inside of Lightroom as well if I want to. So I do love the fact that it is a simple app that just lives in the browser and doesn't use many resources, not lives in the browser, lives up in the menu bar and does not use many resources until it's indexing. Once it's indexing, it takes up a good amount of resources. But again, once you index the first time, unless there's been a dramatic change, like you wipe out the index and start again, it's not going to use that much resources. It just happens in the background. So check out Peakto Search if that is something you are interested in. If you have tried Excire Foto or Excire Search, if you've tried On One's keyword tool, if you've tried any of them out there, Peakto Search is a great option for you to try. So I definitely recommend checking that out.